Hello, hello. So what I'm doing is making the spoil board. What I'm doing is making this foil board for the 30 by 48. And at the moment, it is working on the back side. And what I'm doing is cutting holes for the rivet nuts so that we can clamp it from the top. Insert into the holes. Just like that. See what they look like right here. Got a little recess for that to sit in. It'll slide down in and it'll squeeze. It'll hold in there nice and tight. So I have 196 holes to drill. And I'm using a method called spiral toolpath. The bit I am using is a 3/16 down bit. And the bit is going into the hole in a rotation like that. This is a large board. I figure I'm going to be sitting here drilling holes for a while, so I might as well just go live and talk to you. Pretty much is, Joe. Or watching the grass grow. Well, it sounds a little rough. Thank you. not a very exciting video to watch. Didn't even think about the threat of insects. Next time. That's a really good idea. I'll rewrite it for that. This is the program I'm going to make available. Thanks, Joseph. I'm glad. Joe, yes. That's what I'm making it for. Yeah, so this will be available. I've been working on it for about 2 days now. Maybe three. Probably. Notice my homemade dust shoe. I made that a long time ago on my Bob's CNC. Had it running a little fast. Looks like the tip was getting hot a little bit. Yeah, I'm gonna. I'm using these. They'll be inserted from the back. What's up, Army? You see, right along there, I had to actually surface my table first before I could put the spoil board down to do this. There's too much of that. Hey Jeff, what's going on? Yeah, I know. I'm working on that. I'm getting a, headset with a noise canceling mic and a directional mic. What I'm doing is I'm making the spoil board for the 30 by 48 MK2. Well, this isn't actually the MK2. This is the MK1 with the extension kit on it. The spacing is 4 inches from here to here, and it's 2 inches up and 2 inches over. Yes, this is 3/4 inch, and that's 3/4 inch. Yeah, that inclinometer is very, very cool. We're talking about this thing right here. This is a tool that every CNC router owner needs to get. This inclinometer. I'll try to remember to link this in the video afterwards. You push that, set it on your table, you read your angle, and then you put it up against your router and see if the angle still reads zero. I talked about it on my weekend video. Very cool little device and super inexpensive. It gets an error when you lean it backwards because it's supposed to be upright. Yeah, it works great for checking your tram. It's super, super quick. This is another technique to check your tram as well. Some guy, I saw his YouTube video. So it's about maybe 15 inches long. Put a couple of saw cuts in it, there and there. Drill a 1/4 inch hole. Use a router bit, clamp it in there so it's screwed, clamped, and then another one on the other side. Then you put this in your router, and you check the gap on this side, swing it around, and then check the gap on that side, and then you can adjust your tram. This is actually super accurate doing it this way. And then you can do back and front as well. So super cheap, super easy thing to make if you have 1/4 inch things. So this will just go right up. This will go right up in the router. So one thing you notice, yeah, Joe, you might have seen the same one, I don't know. So you might have noticed that this is doing two things in the same operation, which is not something you normally see in Vectric. It's drilling the hole, and then it comes up, and then it drills the flange, and then it does the next hole, and then drills that flange, and it does it repeatedly. And it's using something called a merged toolpath, which is a video I will have to do, especially if you have a lot of repeat stuff, like 190 holes. Then rather than going to drill all the holes and coming back and doing all the counter bores, it can merge those two tool paths. So you see, I got a screw right there, so we have to be really careful. So I had to run this out first to make sure that I wouldn't hit the screw. So I had to run it, dry run it. I still have quite a few holes to go. Got all these dark colored holes I have to get. No, I have not used the backer. I did once. And by the three-ply Luan that you get at the hardware store, that works. I don't do it enough. Thank you. Looks like I got about 20 more holes to go. Joe, I'm glad you finally made it this time. Tightening. Oh. Yeah, you can feel it when it snugs down on the collet. So, over tightening your collet, you don't need to jam it down. You need to pull it and you feel it, like grab the collet, and just maybe another little tweak, and you'll be fine. This collet's in good shape. I think the router bit has seen its day. I've used this one a lot. Set of calipers, you might want to measure the compression bit. Measure the shank on it. Shank may be a hair low. If you have micrometers, it's better to check it that way. It's getting hot. I've been running at not a good speed. It might. Hi, Tony. Yeah, changing the direction might help. I mean, I'm using a down bit on this. I wouldn't normally use a down bit for drilling, but I'm doing a spiral drill. Normally the chips fall out of the way, so I'll have to think about what I'm doing. I think it's just the spindle speed. I got the router set up. Had it set too high. That's what I created, 196 of these. That gives me clamping ability across the entire working surface of the router. When you have this many holes, sometimes maybe T-Track comes something better to use. Oops, we don't want to do that. I knocked my light over. It fell right on top of my camera. All right, what'd I do? Oh, you know, don't you hate it when you do stuff like that? Everything changes. So I got something on my screen now. Oh well. So I've got about 30 hours on the spoil board, getting the design right. And I don't know how I can turn the screen around. Ah, there we go. What do we got? You get to see a close-up of my face. I got to look really close at the screen to see what you're typing in. Anyway. Yep, so that's what my night is. Now I'm going to start pounding in a bunch of rivet nuts and verify the other side, get it sealed. I've sealed everything on this side. I'll use acrylic, water-based polyurethane. And I'll just put it on nice and heavy. You take a heat gun over it, get it kind of dried off, then I'll put another coat, do the heat gun again, and then a final coat, do the heat gun again, and let it sit 24 hours. And so that seals it up pretty good. And then on the other side, once I get this thing flipped over and surfaced, then I will do the same thing on that side, and then I'll paint it black, and then I'll just shoot a live video of the thing cutting the whole grid out. So that'll be cool. All right, but I'm gonna check out. I just wanted to say hi, and because I was bored. I needed some company. All right, I hope you have a great night, and I'll talk to you soon, working on a video as well, so.